your days long. And the night is yours alone. And you're sure you've had enough of this life.
Our policy here in Paws is to, the main things that we want to get across to people are neutering and microchipping. You cannot get the message about neutering across enough. A lot of the dogs we get dumped here are unwanted puppies, pregnant females, males that have been going off in packs after females and got picked up by dog wardens or whatever. We have an education program going at the moment where I try to get around and visit as many schools as possible. And if you can get the kids and educate them at 10, 12 years old and just say, this is what you should do with your dog. Go home and tell mum and dad that the dog should be neutered. If the dog isn't neutered, it'll have too many puppies and it'll die. You know, if you can get that into a child's mind, then they will go home and they will nag mum and dad until they get the dog neutered. If every dog that we picked up straying around the country had a microchip in it, then we could trace back the owners and they could be prosecuted for what they've done to the animal, because with the ear tagging and the tattooing, that's easily removed. If they kill an animal and dump it, they just take off the ears. It's happened so often. But with microchipping, it's embedded in the animal's skin and there's no way they can get it out. So a dog is always traceable back to the original owner. And in many European countries, it's actually the law. I got a phone call from a gentleman to say that there was a dog in the canal in Strachan. So I dropped everything, drove around to the canal bank. And sure enough, there was this huge German Shepherd in the canal. He had his front paws and his head were on the bank, covered in blood, and the rest of his body was actually submerged in the water. So I brought him to the vet in Selbridge. The vet put up on his screen a photograph of the x-ray, and the dog in fact had 90 shotgun pellets embedded in his head. The dog's jaw was shattered completely here. There was no bridging at all in it. He had the pellets in his head, he had pellets in his eye. But we decided to go ahead with treatment, and we got in touch with the veterinary college in Ballsbridge. They assessed him in the college, did lots of x-rays. Like I said, they'd have a go at sorting him out, but they were talking £2,000 to £2,500. At that stage, the Star newspaper picked it up, and they put him on the front page on a Saturday morning. Over the following fortnight, while the dog was in the vet college having treatment, we got donations of approximately £2,000. It was a long road to recovery. He was in the vet college for about 5 to 6 weeks. He still today, his eye is not 100%. We're not sure whether or not he's going to be able to ever see through it again. Compared to the dog that I pulled out of the canal in April, it's an actual miracle that he has come as far as he's come. But we're happy and he's happy, and everything turned out all right in the end.
Because grace makes beauty out of ugly things.
We also are trying to build a custom-built animal rescue centre for Ireland. At the moment, we're not getting very far as funding is concerned. We're still running it from our house, and we've gone as far as we can go there. We can't really make any improvements because of planning permission. But somebody out there, when they're going to the solicitor, and I know it's something that everybody has to face, and everybody hates facing it, but if you are making your will, please remember us, because we are spending it on the animals, and we're trying to get this message across. Thanks very much.
Game you like to play, pretend you're free for one day. I may beg you. lifting poos, which is very important.
The nasty job.
Yes, they always get a certificate at the end of the year, say who's the best shifter.
It's not all fun and games. These animals need 24 hours of care and attention. It's a full-time task for Deirdre and Gina, but not without its testing moments.
Last Christmas Day, I was here. I had one girl helping me. I had 53 dogs outside. I just said to myself, why am I doing this? Everybody else was enjoying their Christmas dinner and their wine and their fire, and I was out there cleaning out in the yard. But Louise actually turned around to me. She said, Gina, she said, there's 2,000 dogs out there, she said, that have homes today because you're out here doing this. And it made it all worthwhile, you know.
You like to run away, and it's just a game you like to play. Pretend you're free for one day. I may better give your heart away, and it might be good for you. So whatever gets you through. Your home's been built from sacrifice. Might sound good, but it's a night. And you really get to play with a rolling.